This is Paul from Email Octopus, and today I want to show you how easy it is to create and send your first email campaign. From the dashboard, click on the Campaigns tab on the top bar of your screen. Now, before you'll be able to create a campaign, you'll need to have a list with at least one contact in it. It can be your own email address if you haven't built your list just yet, but without that, you won't see an option to create a campaign. As I already have a list with contacts in it, I can start creating my campaign. Since this is my first campaign, the button to create a new one appears here. If I had already sent some before, it would be in the top right corner of the screen. First, we need to title our email. I'll call this one My First Email. This is something your subscribers won't see. It's only for your own records. The next option allows you to choose the sender's name and email address the email will be sent from. Now, we need to add a subject line. Let's start with Hello, and I'm going to add a merge tag to customize it with my subscriber's first name, and I'll finish with an emoji. In the next field, you can type a preview text, which will appear under or next to the subject line in your subscriber's inboxes. It's optional, so if you leave it empty, it will pull the first lines from the content of your email. It's worth using, so I'm going to put your monthly digest is here, and here you can see what it would look like in an inbox. Back to the editor. In the next step, you can choose who will receive your campaign. You can select a whole list or a specific segment, for example, based on your subscribers' tags. I'm just going to choose this list. The advanced settings on the right allow you to turn on or off the ability to track opens or clicks and to personalize the To field. You can also enable Google Analytics tracking here. When you're ready, click Save and Next. If you've chosen a free email address like a Gmail or Outlook as a sender, you might see a pop-up recommending sending from a private domain. Don't worry if you don't have one. We'll make sure your emails are sent from one of our verified domains and your subscribers will still see your address as a sender, so you can click Continue. Now we have moved to the Design step, where we can select our campaign's base template. If you've created any templates beforehand, you will see them here in the Yours section. If you have multiple templates, you can also sort them by name or the last edited date, as well as search for a specific one. In the Inspirational section, you'll find lots of pre-designed templates. And if you'd like to start from scratch, you can select our plain template from the drag and drop section. If you have HTML experience and you'd like to code your campaigns from scratch, you can choose the template from the Code Your Own section. You can also choose from our branded template section. If you have saved your branding during the onboarding process, you'll see your branding automatically applied in those templates. Let's click on the preview button on one of those, and you can see that it already has my logo applied. The fonts used in this template, as well as the button's color, are also those I have saved in my account branding. I'll go back to the Yours section and select one of the templates I created earlier. You can see that we're in the Content tab now, where we can work in the editor and make changes to the chosen template. If you want to create unique campaigns, you have many options to choose from. Most of our templates will already have a logo element included at the top, like you can see here. If you'd like to add new elements, like an image block, you can drag it from the panel you see on the left side. Click on the image block you just added and you'll see the element settings on the left side. When you click on the Change Image button, you can now upload your image from your device, choose from previously added images, or browse through the Pexels free stock image library. You can customize the whole message to match your needs. For example, you can edit the text, change its color and font, include a merge tag such as your subscriber's first name, and insert a hyperlink. You can also use a button to direct your subscribers to a specific URL. All elements can be matched to your brand colors. You can either type the hex code of the color you'd like to use, select one manually in the color tool, or choose one of the colors saved in your account's branding. There's also an option for you to add your own HTML code element if there's something more you'd like to have in your campaign. At the bottom, you can see the social follow buttons. Select the platforms you'd like to use and hyperlink them to your social media profiles. You can also adjust their styling and colors in the left-hand panel. In the Global Settings tab, you can set the default settings for your campaign like the background colors, campaign's width, and font settings. You may also notice the Rows tab. A row is basically a box in which you can place the content blocks. You can select a single column row or one of the multiple column rows. Here, it's worth noting that you can only place rows above or below already existing rows. To check what your email will look like in your subscribers' inboxes, you can go to the Preview and Test section and view the versions for desktop and mobile. By choosing your contact's email address in the Preview As section, you can see what your email will look like with the merge tags rendered in the inbox. You can also use the Send as Test option to send it a test to yourself or someone else on your team. Just insert your email address here and press Send once you're ready. When you're done, click Save and Next. Here you can review everything before sending. You can view all the sections, and if you'd like, you can go back and change something. The campaign can be sent immediately or at a specific date and time. You can also choose a specific time zone. In this example, I'm going to choose to send immediately. I'm happy with my message, so I'm going to click Send. It will ask me to confirm to make sure that I really want to send it, and when you click Send now, you'll see that we're preparing it, and in just a moment, your email will make it to your subscribers. And that's it. I hope you'll give it a try. Thanks for watching, and happy emailing!